Crazy P was a project started by me and Chris Todd many years, many moons ago, about 13 years ago, and it was a hobby project. We called ourselves Crazy Penis first of all, and it was very much a bit of fun, and then ever since then we've just kind of kept going and haven't stopped. So it was we met Danielle along the way in Manchester, and we got the band together over a period of years, and it's just kind of developed into a full live band now and a full, well, half serious project.
Yeah, I'd like to think that I wasn't wasting my life away on something that wasn't serious.
Oh, cheer up.
Okay, sorry.
When we kicked off, which was sort of mid-90s, our main love was house music, because at that point in time there were some brilliant labels kicking off, like Newphonic and Paper, who were kicking off that sort of new sort of British house sound. And I think that's where we were at that point in time. But we always bought a lot of disco, and we always sampled a lot of disco, and we always loved a lot of disco. And I think that once the band came together and we started playing in that band environment, and you hear more music and you get older and your tastes change, and you just want to try new things out.
We've grown up with disco music, we've grown up with soul music, we've grown up with techno music, and I think whatever day we wake up feeling, we might go in the studio and record, and that's reflected, and we don't feel like we need to mould ourselves into any particular sound anymore. It's what we're feeling at that given time. It was a shock that on a Wednesday night, you know, there was that many people out with so much energy, and I think the rawness of the venue as well contributed to the vibe.
I felt like I could, you know, I could play what I wanted, and that's the best way you can possibly feel. And we played quite a lot of disco, and it, you know, went down great. So it's, I think people here are generally open-minded about music and up for it, from what we can see. But it's just nice to come over and see a little pocket of people who know your stuff and who appreciate it. And it was really great. When we first started off working, myself and Chris, we worked on an Atari ST with an Akai sampler. That's all we had, and the sampler was memoried up to the hilt. So that was like our audio recording. We just used to record all the live parts into the sampler and then arrange it in the Atari. And then obviously PCs came along and Logic came along, and then that opened up the whole live recording thing completely. For inspiration, I generally look to you. Yeah.
Good grief, no wonder your life's a mess. One thing I can say that I really, you know, we go through our ups and downs in this industry, and I think one thing that keeps me going is the fact that we are a really, really good, happy family. You know, we've been through a lot together, and I think the sound that you hear, the ever-changing sound that you hear from Crazy P, is down to the fact that we are a family. And anything that we do comes from the soul. It's certainly not attached to finances. The reward comes from each other, the feeling that we create, and the people that we see are inspired by what we do. And I think that's what keeps me going.
That's enough, isn't it? That's what does it.
That's what does it. That's why we're still here. Unfortunately, you're probably going to see us around for a few more years. On behalf of myself and Jim, I would like to say thank you to the OM guys for having us. And we're excited about the tour.
Yes, indeed. And forthcoming gigs. Thanks.
So thanks, OM.